Until recently, I was like many of you, struggling each day to be productive. Each day, I was faced with a gargantuan to-do list. I've always liked that word gargantuan. So rarely do I have an opportunity to use it in a sentence. This is Motion, an artificial intelligence-powered app that turns to-dos into to-dones. Let's get started. I'm Ormond Beckles. In this video, the first in a series, I'll show you step-by-step how to get started with Motion. Please click the subscribe button so you don't miss a video. Motion is a game-changing AI-powered task manager and scheduler. Let's start by defining the two main problems that to-do lists and most task managers have and how Motion fixes these problems. The first problem is that task managers don't know enough about our tasks. Finish writing the business proposal for Joe's store by December 20th. Now, it doesn't know how long I need to complete this task. Is it an hour? Is it 5 hours? Let's say it's 5 hours. Is it better for me to do 1 hour a day for 5 days or a 5 hour marathon session? If something more important comes up, can I move the deadline to the 21st? The second problem is that they don't know enough about us. Do I go to the gym twice a week so that time can't be used? Do I need to pick up my son or daughter at school on a certain day? Maybe you prefer to return phone calls in the afternoon or you're going to be traveling. All of these things go into how a task should be scheduled. In addition, they don't seem to know how many hours there are in a day. Have you ever woken up and your task manager says, you have 116 tasks due today? You spend your morning going through those tasks, prioritizing them, and then the rest of the day trying to play catch up, trying to get them all done. And if something comes up, your whole plan for the day is useless and everything just gets pushed to the next day. So tomorrow it'll say, you have 135 tasks due today. The result is that you spend a lot of time trying to figure out what you're going to do and feeling like you never get anything done. Wouldn't it be great if there was a program that would continuously look at my task, reprioritize them, and schedule them in and around my life? Imagine starting each morning with a lucid, intelligent, thought-out plan for the day. A plan that you just have to follow. And if something unforeseen happens, and it will, it would automatically rearrange things and not just dump everything on to the next day. That's what Motion does. Let me show you how it works.
Using the link below, you'll be brought to Motion and you'll be given the option of trying Motion free for 7 days. You're going to click on that and it's going to ask you to use your Microsoft credentials or your Google credentials. Once you get into Motion, we have a calendar and a section that says tasks. First thing I suggest is go into settings, click on schedules. Schedules are blocks of time that Motion will use to assign tasks to. I have one that says mornings. Mornings are 9 a.m. to 11:30. What that means is if I do assign it and say that this is a morning thing, it will assign it during those times. I have another one after hours. It won't assign this task before 6 o'clock. Here we have work hours, and this one says include lunch. It can assign the task anytime between 9 and 12. It will not assign a task between 12 and 1. It can assign a task between 1 and 5. Fridays are different because I work through lunch and I leave early. Weekends are 11 to 4 on Sunday and 11 to 4 on Saturday. And daytime is anytime between 9 and 5. The best way to understand Motion is to start to use it. Typical items have got pick up Timmy, book a hotel, finish a YouTube video, mount a camera, finish writing a 2,000-page movie script, secure wires under my desk and go swimming. Let's start with finish 2,000-page movie script. I'm going to click on add. I'm going to say finish movie script. We're going to just use the basic parts of it right now. We're going to say finish movie script. and we could put some notes here. This is where it starts to get its intelligence. How long is it going to take us? I have a choice. I can say, look, just remind me to do it. I can put down not sure. I'm going to say that this is going to take me 20 hours. And you can see as soon as I typed in 20, it says 20 hours. Now it asks me, is it okay if I split this into chunks? And if so, what's the minimum chunk duration? Not the maximum, but the minimum. I'm going to say, yeah, you can split it into chunks. And the minimum chunk, by the time I sit down and get my thoughts together, it should be a minimum of 1 hour that you can set aside for doing this. It says, okay, we're going to say 1 hour. What's the importance? I'm going to leave it at medium for right now. And I'm going to pick a hard deadline of the end of the year. I want to have it done before the end of the year. I'm going to say the 31st. It automatically says, well, when do you want to work on it? You're going to start on it as of today, as of right now, as soon as we're done.
And then it asks, which one of
these schedules do we want to use? And that's why I said I may say I only want to work on it at the end of the day, after hours, anytime, 24/7. Or I could even click custom and put in some kind of a custom time. In my case, I'm going to put daytime. That means anytime between 9 and 5. I'll go ahead and I'll click schedule. And now what it's going to do is you'll see this recalculating task. You'll see this a lot. And what it's now done is it's taken that one task that we gave it and it's now assigned it. Now we're at 3 minutes of 4 and it says, look, as far as I can tell, starting at 4 o'clock, we can work on this and we can work on it from 4 to 5. Then it says, hey, you know what? Tomorrow morning we can start on it from 9. Now remember we said minimum, not maximum, but minimum. It says, hey, you can work on it from 9 to 11. Then you can work on it from 11 to 1:15, and then you can work on it. And again, I may stick to that schedule or more than likely not, but that's okay. Let's take a look at another one. Pick up little Timmy. Oh, I have to pick up little Timmy every day between 2 and 3. So that's not a task, that's a must. So I'm gonna make that an event. An event. I'm gonna click on the plus sign. I'm gonna click on event and I'm gonna say pick up. Little Timmy. And that is going to start tomorrow. And that is going to be 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. We'll make it interesting. We'll say 3:30. And it says, does it repeat? Yes, it does. And we're going to say it's on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Somebody else picks them up, so I don't care. And then Friday. And then it says, when do we want to end this? And we're going to say he's off starting Christmas Eve, so we'll stop there. Now, once we hit create, it's going to go off and start to figure out what to do. Now, you can see it has pick up little Timmy, but it has movie script. It's now figuring out that we can't do both of those at the same time. And as you can see, picking up little Timmy has a higher priority, so it got rid of that movie script. And what it's now done is push that to next week. And if we go back to next week, you can see we have quite a few finished movie scripts because it says, hey, we got to get this done. And as you can see, we're all set except for Thursday. Remember, we don't have to pick up little Timmy on Thursday, so we are all set. Let's come up with another one. We have go finish this video. Oh, we got to finish this video. So I'm going to click on add task and I'm going to say finish YouTube video. That's going to take about 2 hours. I can split that into chunks and I can really work on it for 30 minutes. It has a hard deadline for Friday and we'll start on it today. And it can be anytime during the daytime and we'll say schedule. Now it now thinks, by the way, that we're supposed to be working on this movie script. There's a little button that popped up here while we were doing that. Hopefully it'll come back again. And it says, start doing this. Now, if we do it, fine. Now, if we don't, it will realize it because we didn't check it off and we didn't hit the button and it will start moving things around so that it works out that we get this job done. That's why I said this is different from a project manager, because in a project manager, you have to make all the decisions as to how things are going to be done. Whereas in this case, it's going to do all of this for us. Now you can see it says finish YouTube video. It's got it from 9 to 11, and I should be all set there. Now I've got, oh, you know what? I have a phone call on Friday. I'm going to click on create an event, and I have a phone call. I have a phone call on Friday, and that phone call is going to be from 8:30 because out there, I'll say 8:30, and that's going to go to 9:30. No, you know what? They're going to talk a lot. We'll say 10:30. And I'm going to go ahead and click on that. If you've got a phone call between 8:30 and 10:30, you can't be working on the YouTube video then. So it's now pushed that YouTube video from 10:45 to 12:45. And this is the glory of it. As I start adding things and giving it different priorities, it will automatically start changing my schedule to fit this. Let's take a look else and see what we have. Secure wires under my desk. That's something I have to do right away. I'm going to go ahead and click on task. The difference between a task and an event is a task is something that you want to get done. An event is something that you have to get done. It doesn't shift that you can't. You have to pick up such and such at the airport. You have to do this. You have to do that. You have to make this phone call. So I'm going to say secure wires on your desk. And in this case, it says the duration. I say it's going to take about 30 minutes. But I'm going to say, look, that needs to be done ASAP because we can't have, that's got to be done. And it needs to be done in one go. And I'll go ahead and I'll schedule that. What it's done is it said, look, the phone call, you got to do this phone call. Then you can secure these wires. And then you can finish your YouTube video. You've got some time. And then you can pick up little Timmy. I actually really enjoy throwing things at Motion just to see how it will twist and turn and fit everything in. Now in the morning, I have a lucid, intelligent, well thought out plan. If something happens and I don't do one of these or something happens, it will just rearrange things for me. I don't have to come back into Motion. It will figure it out. Because if I don't tell it I did it, then it assumes I didn't do it. This is just the tip of the iceberg. I normally sit down Sunday night, reevaluate all of my items, and then I let Motion deal with it for the rest of the week. As we go through the week, it will shift things based upon whether I do them or don't do them, what times, what other items come up. It will figure everything out.
In the next video in this series, I'll show you how to create a project and task template, which is a huge time saver, especially if you have something that has a lot of steps to it that's very repetitive. For example, I use that for making YouTube videos. Will you be using Motion to make your life easier? Leave a comment below. Please help us get to 25,000 subscribers by clicking the subscribe button. We really need your support in order to keep the channel going. Or you can help support the channel by becoming a member. Or if you found this video super helpful, consider clicking on the thank you button. Until the next video, this is the High Tech Nomad signing out.